Good morning and welcome to this episode of Fathers and Sons. Many years back, somebody asked me, who can be a good teacher? Then I was not knowing the answer. Then I was telling he should be educated. I was giving him a lot of guesses. But that person said everything is wrong. And he told me the right answer. The right answer is this. One who is a good student is a good teacher. So in the same note, I want to say, who can be a good father? A good father is someone who can be a good son. So it is very important that fathers were once sons, and fathers need to honor their fathers and honor their fathers like a good son. That is a qualification of a father. Today many of us want to be good fathers, but are you a good son? Today, if your son is going to work with you or behave with you in the same way you are behaving with your father, will it be acceptable? The way you back answer your daddy, if your son back answers you, will you tolerate it? Or if you are behaving in a particular manner with your own daddy, will you allow your son to do the same thing? My friends, it's a hard question. You better ask yourself whether you are a good son. What is the mark your father will give you of your sonship? Okay? If we evaluate your sonship from 1 to 10, okay? 10 being the best, 1 being the worst, what mark you will get? As a son, what mark you will get? Your father will give you the best. I'll tell you, you will be the best father. If your father is not giving you the best, you may not be the best father. My friends, what you are is what you will beget. You can never teach anyone what you do not know. And you can never take anyone to the place where you have not gone. It's very important that every father be a good son first. My friends, let me tell you, if you are a father, your son should know that how much you honor your father, how much you value your father. In fact, when your father and you are there in front of him, how you deal with your dad, how respectful you are with your dad, how service-minded you are with your dad, how you deal with him, how you relate with him, how you serve him, is something for your children to see. Many children learn, you know, obedience and honoring the father and mother from their own fathers and mothers. So you need to be a living example to teach your children how to honor your father. Let me tell you, before you become a good father, you should become a good son. Be an obedient son. Be a son who will honor the father. Sometimes it is true that the fathers cannot be honored because their life is so disturbed and far from what is right. It is very difficult for the children to, you know, honor the parents, honor the father. But the Bible doesn't have any account of all these things. It just bluntly says, honor your father and your mother so that it will be well with you and you will live long on this earth. My friends, today it is our important duty to have a father and to honor him and to be a son of his appreciation. It is very important that you are a son who can be appreciated by your daddy. When you can come to that place, I tell you, you will beget children who will also be appreciated by you. In fact, by doing this, you automatically bring the values and the seeds of honoring a father inside your children. Friends, honor your father and your mother, and all these things will be well with you, and you will live long on this earth. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, we praise you for your goodness. Lord, help us to honor our parents. Help us to be good fathers ourselves so that we beget good sons. We bless every family who is taking part in this. In Jesus' name we pray.